Good morning. Hope you guys are doing well. I'm drinking my tea out of my donut mug. It's 42 degrees here. Social media is like such a powerful tool, and I feel like you can do so much with it. You can connect with so many people. I've been able to help so many people through it. But I also feel like there's another side to social media, you know, a double-edged sword, right? Where I feel like sometimes it brings a little bit of hecticness to your brain. Like, I think sometimes it makes your brain think quickly in these poor, like, shallow, short thoughts that are unimportant. You get wrapped up in things that are completely pointless. And sometimes I feel like social media has drama that's, you know, it just draws your attention to it for no reason. It kind of just wastes your time. And I think anything that really, like, defocuses you is important to notice that you're letting it defocus you, no matter what it is. But I think social media and screen time is an easy one to identify. And if you are noticing that it's either distracting you from the time you're spending with your significant other, your friends that you're with, or even just yourself and like whatever your purpose or focus or mission or whatever it is that you're trying to do that's productive, if you're being defocused from that, I think it's important to identify it and then try to fix it. And if you can't fix it, escape it for a while and see if that balance can fix it. And I think it's just good for me to get away a little bit from everything, but especially social media for a while. San Diego, I feel like, is very calming. It's very relaxing. It's definitely one of the best places on earth. It's hot. It's shorts and short sleeve weather all the time. And I feel like a lot of times when you're in a place that has a lot of comfort, it breeds comfort, right? So when you are so relaxed and stuff, it doesn't push you to do other things. It doesn't push you to, I guess, be your sharpest version. And I think like there's balance, right? I think there's times that you need to be comfort and you need to be relaxed and you need to just like enjoy yourself in the moment. And I think there's other balance where you need to be a bit uncomfortable, be a bit out of your, you know, your zone, and I don't know, test yourself. And I think it helps sharpen your edge and keep your edge sharp. And I think that's where I am right now. The reason that I left San Diego for the last couple of days now, I'm in a place called Malibu Creek with two of my really, really, really good friends. And I just needed to get out of there. I just needed some balance, I guess. When I'm out with my friends in nature, there's no technology, there's no social media, there's no digital presence at all. It's just like how it was 1,000 years ago, minus the fact that we're at a state park and it's like staffed and stuff, you know, they like keep it nice and there's no like mountain lions killing us or whatever. But you see what I'm saying? Like, you know, when we're cold, we make a fire. When we need to heat up, we boil water. When we're hungry, we make our food. You know what I mean? We're not able to just like get food. We're not able to just turn on the heat. And for me, I really like that. It really recharges me. Hold on, let me drink a little bit of this tea. And I've realized in the past, I've allowed myself to not be exactly who I am. And I think a lot of it has to do with comforts. I feel like it has a lot to do with just falling into, I don't know, just like a certain way of living in a certain place because you get in a certain routine. And I think routines, for me, they're good because I'm a machine, you know what I mean? Like, that's part of my personality is I like plans, I like structure, and I can stick to it for years. I mean, if you know who my dad is, by the way, he started losing fat. His Instagram is Dad Loses Fat. He's been drinking juice for 27 years. Yeah, he's obese. He's, you know, gained a bunch of weight. But even through that, even when eating bad foods, he's always woken up and drinking juice every single morning, even though, you know, tastes terrible, right? But the point is, like, I come from that. That's my genetics. He's a machine. When I get into a routine, I stick to that routine, and I'm a machine. But it's important to break the routine, I think, because the routine sometimes turns you into a machine, and a machine is cold. And I think sometimes there's value in that, but I think sometimes you need to get the balance of going away from your routine. And that's exactly what's going on right now. Just getting away from all the screens and stuff, getting out into nature, being away from people in general, because San Diego is very popular. There's a lot of people. So a bit of solidarity, because like right now I've been up for the last 3 hours by myself, just out in the middle of like literally nowhere, being cold and just enjoying myself, you know, running around a little bit so I can warm up. I love that kind of stuff, man. I love, there's a word called austerity, which is like removing comforts or just being away from comforts, just being a part of discomfort, I guess. It's a new word to me. And I just think that's a really cool word because like I'm in solidarity, I have austerity. And of course I do have my two boys right here right now, my two best friends in the world. And It's just a good recharge. I guess my point of this video is I just wanted to say, you know, sometimes I think you need to get away from whatever it is that you are part of to clear your mind. You don't necessarily need to do it the way I'm doing it, right? Like, everybody's different. Everybody has a different core essence or personality, or however you want to put it. And I think, you know, some people really live in comfort and they really love it. Some people really live in discomfort, they really love it. Some people are in routine, they really love it. Some people are like literally all over the place, they love it. Some people are just feeling all the time. Some people are structuring all the time. However it is for you, I feel like finding the opposite is good sometimes. If you live somewhere where you're all alone all the time, maybe it's good to go somewhere where there's lots of people and you can get lots of energy from lots of people and receive it all at once and then go back to where you are. Or for me, get out here in the middle of nowhere and just be by myself for a lot of few days. More tea. This kind of thing definitely recharges me though. So I don't know, I just kind of want to turn this on and talk to you guys real quick. I don't do these sit-down talk videos quite as much as I used to, and I just felt like sharing my mind with you guys this time. I hope this was insightful or you just enjoyed kind of hearing what's going on in my mind. I've been feeling fantastic about my life. I've been feeling so motivated, so clear. I feel like I know exactly where I want to go with everything, but I have been feeling this strong pull for the past couple of months to get out into nature, and so I just organized this trip because I really wanted to be able to, like I said, get balance. And I think if maybe you're feeling unbalanced right now, maybe you feel like there's something you need to do to change things up, it might be, maybe this is your wake up call. Because this is amazing and it makes me want to do it again. But you know, in another 6 months when I need balance again, this is probably one of the only times that I'm gonna be thinking about social media while I'm out here. And since I'm on that track, next month in January, I'll be staying in LA with John Venus and Derek Simnett for a month. It's gonna be a really freaking awesome time. And then in June, sometime around June, we're gonna be doing season 5 of the YouTube House. So look out for that. I'm really, really excited about that. I think that's it. They've got a lot of cool stuff coming up in the future. If you did enjoy this video, please let me know what you thought in the comments below. Give it a big old thumbs up. Let me know if you guys have something that you do that balances you that maybe other people could benefit from too as well. Put it in the comments below and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. CT.
Lift heavy or die Myron, motherfucker.
Team me up, CT.
Lift heavy.